Good morning, dear students. Myself, Vikas Prajapati, assistant professor from Sri Sitarambhai Naranji Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrak. In semester 3, one common subject for all branch, that is effective technical communication. Our subject code is 313004. Now today, I will teach you on topic public speaking. Let's see, first of all, what is the rule of speaking? Effective speaking is the most frequently required skill for any professional as well as for in a day-to-day life also. It involves the ability to express one's message effectively to the audience through spoken words. Message can be delivered face to face or by using any electronic device also. Speaking skill is required in various forms such as conferences, meetings, seminars, group discussions, etc. Let's see what are the types of speaking. We speak on different occasions to achieve different goals or to serve different purposes. Based on the purposes, we can classify the speaking into three types. First one, task oriented speaking. Number two, interpersonal speaking. Number three, semi-formal and informal speaking. Let's see, first of all, what is task oriented speaking? When we have to speak in order to perform a particular task or assignment, we may need to contact other people face to face or by using telephone or any other media. Sometimes we may also have to attend teleconferences with multiple people. Such speaking is called task-oriented speaking. The following are the some situations that required the task-oriented speaking. For the purpose of to collect data, for the purpose of to eliciting information, addressing people to motivate or pursue them, interviewing somebody for preparing articles for a magazine, conducting a research, inquiring about something, negotiating a deal. These all are the situations that required the task-oriented speaking. Interpersonal speaking is mostly relationship-oriented. Relationship-oriented speaking is connected with building new relationships or keeping alive the existing relationship. Conversations, counseling, group discussion, team communication, etc. may be grouped under the interpersonal speaking. At the time of interpersonal speaking, we are using some of the phrases or expressions such as I thank you, I respect you, I am with you, you can count on me, I will be there, I understand you, tell me more about it, I think you are right, it is a pleasure talking to you. These are some of the phrases or expressions that we are using when we are doing interpersonal speaking. Third one, semi-formal and informal speaking. For example, like you are working as a production engineer in a reputed automobile company and you are invited to attend the wedding of one of your junior managers. In the wedding, you meet one of your classmates. Now, if you speak to employee who is getting married, your speaking may be termed as semi-formal speaking, as you are still his boss though both of you are not in a office. On the other hand, your speaking to your classmate may be called informal, as he does not belong to your workplace. Simply, we can say that semi-formal speaking, it means you are speaking with your any employees or any colleagues from outside the organizations, then that speaking are called semi-formal speaking. And the people that is not belong to your organizations and you are speaking with his or her, then that speaking are called informal speaking. When we speak with our friends, family members, relatives, etc., in order to exchange personal informations, then we can say that it's called informal speaking. The message, language, style and structure we use differ from when we speak in formal setting. Now, what is the meaning of persuasive speaking? Persuasion is an art as well as a psychological process. It always occurs in a situations where two or more points of view exist. For instance, we may have our own views on values, policies, principles, certain techniques, etc. This may be complete opposite to or different from the views of our listener. However, with our power of persuasion, we may be able to make people agree with us on many matters. We may notice that everyone among us might have been convinced or persuaded by a speaker by one to more of their following attributes. For the purpose of to persuasive speaking, you require the following attributes. First of all, that is credibility. If the person says persons have the good credibility in the market, then audience are convinced. Then another thing, that is evidence. At the time of speaking, you have to show some evidence, past year performance, then people are convinced. Reasoning, it means you have to show some statistics to audience, then people will convince. At the same time, you can use any emotional appeal also. Just like you, all of you aware about that, majority of the insurance companies shows the emotional appeal in advertisement. You have to show any emotions and try to convince the people, just like same as the insurance companies use the emotions. Which emotions? Anybody aware about that? They are showing the fear. They are showing the fear emotions. If you are not purchasing that policy, then you face the problem. So that way, you can show any emotions in your speaking and try to convince the people. So there are very few people that are good in persuasive speaking because he or she have credibility, evidence, reasoning and emotional appeal, this type of attributes, then he or she can do persuasive speaking. Now let's see, what is public speaking? Public speaking need not necessarily mean speech we deliver in front of a large number of people. Public speaking, it means aisa nahi hai ki you have to speak in front of a large number of people. Look at the following situations. As an intern in a company, you have been involved in two projects. Towards the end of your internship, you have the opportunity of getting absorbed by that industry. For this chance, you need to speak to your project manager and the vice president about the task you have handled in the project. So here only two, three people are there. One that is project manager and another that is vice presidents or any other one to higher level people. But here your purpose is clear and you are delivering a content, then that speaking also called a public speaking. During your graduation party, you need to speak to a gathering of your batchmates and your family members about your experience at the college. That also called a public speaking. You are participating in a group discussion and you have to convince your listeners about your view. That situation is also called a public speaking. It means public speaking, it means not just like you have to speak in front of a large number of people. If you have a purpose is clear and there are very few people are also available and then you are speaking, that speaking is also called a public speaking. All these situations involve public speaking. To perform well in these situations, one need to know the characteristics of good public speaking. All these situations demand you to plan, visualize, organize, and draft your speaking. Now see some of the essentials of good public speaking. For the purpose of good public speaking, these are the essentials. That is clarity of purpose, audience awareness, familiarity with the location, collection and selection of content, outlining, organization of content, selection of suitable mode of delivery, effective use of body language, voice, visual aids, starting on time, objectivity, planning and preparation, answering questions. So these all are the essential of good public speaking. Public speaking. First step, that is draft the speech. A beginner in public speaking needs to write down the entire speech. Preparing the first draft of a speech may be the most challenging task, but the first draft should not be considered as the final draft. Hence, the first draft need to be edited according to our purpose, audience, and time. A. Preparing the first draft. For the purpose of preparing the first draft, there are some of the tips. Set a deadline and complete your first draft at least 3 days before the date of delivery so that you have time for editing, revising, etc. Arrange your points in bullets form, in words, phrases, or sentences. Do not bother about the sequence. If you cannot get ideas for introduction, you can start with main text also. Do not worry about the coherence or flow of your speech now. Do not mind if your speech is longer or shorter than it is required for the given time. This can be adjusted at later stage. Do not bother about vocabulary at this point. You can correct or change word during the preparation of the final draft. So these are some of the tips at the time of preparing the first. Now preparing the final draft. After preparing first draft, you have to edit and then after prepare the final draft. So preparing the final draft, there are some of the tips. Check the content for focus, every point, statistics, example, visual aid should support the core idea or not. Edit floor clarity. Check whether the idea have been arranged logically so that they do not confuse the audience. Check the conciseness. Ask yourself this question: is this essential? If the answer is no, cut that part of the first draft. Replace long and different words with short and easy word. Eliminate sentences from paragraph if they do not support the main idea. Edit for smooth flow. Check for impact, insert analogies, vivid image, quotes, smiles, metaphors, etc. for creating an impact on the audience. Highlight the words or phrases you need to emphasize during your speech that you have to highlight. Now practicing public speaking. Even if you rehearsal one, you may be able to improve the effectiveness of your public speaking for the purpose of to improve the effectiveness of your public speaking, practicing public speaking that is required. With the help of practice, you can work on some of the points and you can improve on that area. With the help of practice, you are aware about that, whether your speech is delivered within the allocated time or not. By practicing public speaking, you are aware about that, whether you are able to retain your energy and enthusiasm at the last or not. With the help of practicing public speaking, you are trying to control your nervousness also. Then another thing, that is whether you are using appropriate words and phrases in speaking or not, that also. So these are some of the areas where you can improve with the help of practicing public speaking. So after preparing final draft, finally you have to practice your public speaking, then you can improve on that area. So all about to public speaking. Thank you all of you.